Hi friends, today we are going to study the PoleZero representation of a system. So, PoleZero representation of a system. For example, we know the transfer function h of z is represented as z minus z1 into z minus z2 divided by z minus p1 into z minus p2, and this could go on till z minus, let us say, zm, and this could also go till z minus pn, because the difference equation is nth order with respect to x and nth order with respect to y. Now, what is this numerator and what is this denominator stands for? Now, for example, if I put z is equal to z1, then this term will turn to 0. So, if I put z is equal to z1, then this term will turn to 0. So, this will cancel out to 0. Now, if you multiply 0 by any number, it will convert to 0. So, the numerator of this polynomial will go to 0. Now, 0 divided by any number is representing a 0 or results into 0. So, we have, if we put z is equal to z1 or z2 or z3 or so on till zm, then my h of z will go to 0. So, if I put any value of z which is equating to z1, z2, z3 or zm, then my h of z will go to 0. Hence, z1, z2, z3 and zm are called as zeros of system. They are called as zeros of system, because they take the transfer function to 0, they are denoted as zeros of system. Similarly, if we have h of z equals to z minus z1, z minus z2 and so on till z minus zm divided by z minus p1 into z minus p2 and so on till z minus pn, then now if I put z equals to p1, then what will happen? If I put z equals to p1, then this term will be going to 0. Now 0 multiplied by any number would result into 0. Any number divided by 0 result into infinity. So, if I put z is equal to p1 or p2 similarly to pn, then my h of z will turn out to infinity. Hence, p1, p2 and so on till pn is called as poles of a system. So, we have seen two entities of a system. One are numerator entities, which we called as the zeros of a system, and denominator entities, which we called as poles of a system. Zeros normally, or zeros takes the h of z to 0, whereas poles take it to infinity. So, wherever we have a pole, that time the transfer function will be infinity, and wherever we have a 0, that time the transfer function is 0. How to graphically plot this? So, this is our z plane. We call this as a z plane, in which we have a real part of z and an imaginary part of z, and in z transform everything is on a circle. So in a Z plane, we have two axes, real Z and imaginary Z, and everything is on a circle. A very important circle in a Z plane is called as a unit circle. This is a unit circle because the radius of that circle is 1. Now, whenever I wanted to represent Z is equal to P1 or Z is equal to Z1, if I wanted to represent P1, then we will use a cross mark. So let us say that Z is equal to P1 lies somewhere over here. So this is P1. Z is equal to Z1 probably lies somewhere around here. So whenever I am representing a pole, I will put a cross mark. And whenever I am representing a zero, I will put a zero mark. So each transfer function will have two entities. The numerator entities are called as the zeros and the denominator entities are called as the poles. And they are represented on Z plane. Poles are represented by cross marks and zeros are represented by circles. Thank you.